WRC-TV.
It's a happy night tonight for Maria Castilla. She was reunited today with her kidnapped baby girl.
Reunited at last. Three-year-old Danielle Ani had not seen her mother for 1 year. She was abducted by her father illegally.
I had hired like about 7 PI, private detectives, and nobody would come up with anything.
Castillo's success came after she called Mark Miller. Since they don't charge for their services, they've been going out on the weekend selling M&Ms and lemonade to raise money. Co-founders, Channel 2 News, Nightcast.
When Jimmy Watson found out her child was abducted, she went to these men for help. Today, a mother and her son reunited.
Yes!
The story of a mother from Dallas who had a very happy holiday weekend. She was reunited with her son just days before Thanksgiving. He had been missing for more than a year. Today, she has a group of underground detectives to thank for her son's return. Here's Bonnie Strauss.
Jimmy Watson has not seen her son, 8-year-old David Hamden, for almost a year and a half. Last August, the association took on the search for David Hamden. They tracked David's father to Denver. Inside Edition followed Mike Kramer and Mark Miller of the association and David's mother, Jimmy, to Colorado just over a week ago as they closed in on David's abductor. Devising a plan, it was learned that Hamden was in the building. It was then that the police went to the office for the arrest.
Yes!
Jimmy was overcome with emotion as she saw police arrest David's father, Imad. She knew it meant she'd soon be reunited with her son.
Eyewitness News, San Antonio's top-rated satellite newscast.
Good afternoon. What began as a bitter divorce 3 years ago escalated into a two-month search for two little girls hidden from their father.
As Tony Farmer reports, the trail began in Houston and ended in San Antonio with the arrest of the children's grandmother.
I had all the evidence to show that they were being abused and mentally abused and physically abused. And there's been accusations of a sexual abuse.
The girls say their grandmother, 55-year-old Geraldine Isaac, arrested and charged with interfering in a child custody case, made up names for them so no one would catch on to her scheme. For William Hall, it's time to start being a dad again.
Oh, no, just hug him, kiss him.
Continental Airlines picked up the airfare as the Halls returned to Houston with a brand new start. Tony Fama, Channel 5 Eyewitness News.
And now, TV2 Eyewitness News.
Jeannie Van Conant is counting her blessings tonight. A two-year-long nightmare is over. Her kidnapped daughter has been returned safe and sound.
This is where Jeannie last saw little Angela 2 years ago. Jeannie and her husband Donald lived here at this trailer home in New Baltimore for 2 months. Until one night, she claims Donald got angry and snatched Angela. And amazingly, although she was only 2 years old at the time, the little girl can recall the events from that night.
When he did that, he really knocked her down and grabbed me away from her and really ran past her.
Since that time, Jeannie says she's been living in a nightmare. How happy are you?
I'm happy.
The Houston-based American Association for Lost Children assisted police in Angela's recovery.
For 7 years, a young mother searched for her missing daughter. Her last hope was a Houston-based group of child hunters, and they came through, mounting a stunning raid. Steve Wilson with our story.
Dear Heavenly Father, Lord Jesus, we just thank you for everything. And Lord, we just commit ourselves to you.
They consider themselves vigilantes for God. Their mission? Find this woman's missing daughter, Carol.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Tonight, these six men and women want to track down an alleged abductor and reunite Phyllis Ross. There's an Oklahoma arrest warrant out for Larry Ware for child stealing. The child's grandmother believes she knows why Larry took Carol.
Mainly to hurt us, that's all I can think of.
Finally, Carol's grandmother read about a group that reunites missing children with their families, and she wrote a letter.
When God laid it on me to write the letter, that I believed that he had a hand in it, he was ready for us to have the child back.
The American Association for Lost Children agreed to take up the case, and Phyllis considers the group her last chance. A string of sheriff's cars leave for the trailer park, and plenty of reinforcements come along.
Sheriff's Department, open the door.
Officers are sure now that Ware is inside.
After 7 long years, mother and daughter could be reunited in minutes.
Out here.
Finally, the moment comes.
Carol, is that you? Oh, God.
She's a great mother. She's done all this.
In 1987, when Robert was just 4 years old, he was abducted, and he's been missing ever since. For 5 years, Tom Cloak hasn't had a clue as to his son's whereabouts. Tom and Candace heard about a tiny nonprofit group, the American Association for Lost Children. They called, and the group began searching for Robert. How long did it take you to find her?
Within 3.5 weeks.
They issue a warrant for the arrest of Penny Cloak, the boy's mother. Tom Cloak, on this night, has finally found his son.
Did you ever ask Mommy where your daddy was?
I'm your daddy.
No, she told me I had no daddy.
That's not true.
Did you see? That's Little Rock. Remember all the sandcastles we made?
Sandcastles. Wow.
I remember that.
Do you remember that?
I'm starting to remember.
I took you to the beach. I'm your daddy, Robert.
This is a day Mark Hurt thought might never come. After a torturous 15 months apart, he's finally being reunited with his two young sons. The woman who took them, none other than the boy's mother and Mark's ex-wife, Nina. Mark, an Air Force sergeant, testified during his divorce that Nina was an irresponsible mother with a violent temper. Early this year, as a last hope, Mark turned to the American Association for Lost Children, run by Mark Miller, a former stockbroker who's devoted his life to finding missing children. By following Nina's family tree, Mark Miller and his investigators soon tracked this runaway mom and the boys to relatives in North Carolina. But by the time they moved in, Nina was gone. Long days of surveillance proved fruitless. After months on the case, they were as frustrated as ever. But they soon learned that Nina and the boys moved to this house. By now, investigators knew that Nina had changed the boys' names and dyed their hair red. Then, after countless hours of watching and waiting, the hard work paid off.
Tears of joy tonight at Miami International Airport, where a mother and her little daughter are seeing each other for the first time in 5 years. On the Night Beat, Eyewitness News reporter Peter Dange tells us it's a story of an abduction and a transatlantic journey.
6-year-old Anna Maria Silvera is back home with the mother she had not seen in 5.5 years. She is about to meet her brother David for the first time ever. Her father reportedly kidnapped Anna Maria from his ex-wife's Fort Lauderdale home to Germany. At the time, the mother was 7 months pregnant and her son David. Last night, after a 6-month search, the association's founder and 2 investigators and Anna Maria's mother found the child at her father's home in Germany. That led to this reunion.
Well, from here, to see my mommy and my brother David.
I think I was in shock because I just never dreamed it would have transpired. I've been through so many doors being slammed shut in my face, you know, that had it not been for the American Association for Lost Children, I might not have seen her until she was an adult.
First up, a story on the emotional edge. Inside Edition has been following a man who finds missing kids, children who are often kidnapped by bitter parents involved in custody disputes. As Bonnie Strauss tells us, these situations are always intense.
This is a day Donna Rucker and her second husband, Bruce, had begun to think might never come. For almost a year, they've been searching for Donna's sons. Now, at last, they're on the verge of being reunited. A former stockbroker turned private investigator now devotes his life to finding missing children. He has tracked Donna's boys to the tiny Tennessee town of Greenbrier. The arrest is over without a struggle. Donna is rushed from the police station to be with her boys.
I really love you guys a bunch. I missed you guys so much.
At the police station, the boys adjust to being with their mother. They've been through a traumatic year on the run that included a stay in the Dominican Republic.
I just found out that the little boy had 2 ticks in his head, how they had to live with rats, and they had some kind of boils on their body, and the conditions that they hardly ate much, and they've lost weight.
For nearly 2 years, Jackie Gatewood wondered where her children were, whether they were safe, whether they cried for her at night. The last time Jackie saw her kids, they were with their dad, a man she believed could hurt them. For months, police searched for the missing children. Jackie was frantic. She had one last resort. Jamie O'Rourke has the inside story of a family on the run and what finally stopped them.
On the ground, right now.
Watch out for my kids.
I said get on the ground right now.
The long arm of the law finally caught up with 38-year-old Donovan Delphia Gatewood in Texarkana, Arkansas.
Freeman's rights.
You may have seen his crime on a milk carton. A year and a half ago, he stole his own two kids, Anna and Emily.
You have the right to have all your...
From the doorway of their mobile home, 4-year-old Emily watched without expression as her father was handcuffed and taken away. For the mother, Jackie Gatewood, sleepless nights and unbearable pain were finally over.
I was glad I had her back. It's okay. It's all right. It's been 20 months since I've seen them.
No.
The children don't even know their own identities.
If you ask them their names, they don't know their names. You know, except for what I've just told them. What's your name?
Tony.
And what's her name?
Dana.
See, it's Emily and Anna. They don't even know their own names.
Jackie fears she will make darker discoveries about the private lives of her two little ones and their father. Jackie says she would never have found her children without help. Law enforcement officials are saying the same thing. Here's the man getting all the credit.
This is going to be your favorite t-shirt, see? What do you think, you like it?
Mark Miller heads up the nonprofit American Association for Lost Children in Houston, Texas.
There is reason to believe that one or both daughters was sexually assaulted. By the way, the American Association for Lost Children operates on donations. Parents don't have to pay for their kids to be rescued.
Channel 2 News, nightcast.
And a mother's 8-year-long search for her missing daughter is finally over tonight. As Bill Pounders reports, the thanks goes to a Houston-based charity organization.
Martha Laura waits at this Houston area junior high school to see her daughter Catherine for the first time in 8 years and take her back to New Jersey. In her hand, a stuffed animal and a shoe, the only reminder she has of her little girl, who was taken from her by a divorced husband who took the law into his own hands.
It was 7 o'clock in the morning, the usual time that he used to bring her. I was at the window waiting for her, and she never came back.
It wasn't until Martha contacted the American Association for Lost Children, a Houston-based nonprofit organization dedicated to finding missing kids, before she got results.
I got my daughter back.
She'll spend the night here to get used to the little girl, and then she's going to head on up to New Jersey.
She's saying hi. She's smiling at me. She knows I'm a mother.
Bill Pounders, Channel 2 News Nightcast.
Emotional reunion, and tonight friends are reporting that little Catherine is excited to be going home with her mother.
Gosh, what an incredible story.
It really is.
Oh, man.
There's a blessing when we sacrifice.